Chile, you know, Chile in South America, they have a big problem with drought. And what they have done is perfected fog catchers, harvesting drinking water from the fog. Literally, it's essentially it's a mesh, or it can be a kind of webbing, and depending on how it's made and constructed and various, you can actually get the condensation from the fog as it passes over it. The condensation collects and it collects into a bottle, and they have drinking water for free from the air.
That's badass.
It's totally.
So, I love the conservatives who are like, you know, God gave us the oil underneath the ground. So, and then they become Southern. So the good Lord put it there so that we can utilize it, okay? And these liberals don't understand. Well, the good Lord also gave us the sun, he also gave us wind, and he gave us fog.
Yes.
Right? So now we're utilizing fog to get water. It's not about energy, it's about water, but that's great. Now, I worry about it though, and you probably know a hell of a lot more about this than I do. Like, if you did that in LA, the fog would also be littered with smog,
well,
and I wouldn't
see,
want to drink that water.
It depends on how you do it. Now, the thing that they did in Chile is that they adjusted the materials that they used, they adjusted the coating that was on it. Actually, literally, it makes a difference, the size of the holes in the mesh, that whether or not they actually are the optimum amount to capture all of the water. And I didn't see anything about pollution in this particular explanation of this, but I would think that since it's kind of like a distillation, you know, where you actually kind of purifies the water, so I would think, I have to check on that, but I would think that the smog and pollution or particulate matter that we get a lot of here in LA would not make it into the drinking water, depending on if they filter it and how it's constructed.
So are you surprised that we haven't solved how to get energy out of the sun yet in an efficient, you know, cost-efficient way? And maybe we have, and
we
Okay.
See, what they there was a study that came out today. It shows that China and the lower cost for their solar panels that they've been able to achieve isn't necessarily because they have lower labor costs. That is a factor. That does make a difference. But it's really because they were able to scale up so quickly. It was the massive construction of manufacturing plants that they did and the massive scaling up of the production of the PV solar panels that they enabled them to bring the cost down so completely over just a few years. So, you know, when you have scaling up, I mean, it's a very common business practice that when you have economy of scale, you can lower the price quite dramatically.
So that's why, for example, subsidies would make sense in new emerging industries so that they can scale up.
Yeah.
Whether it's solar energy, wind energy,
well, you know, it's the VC valley of death. You know, you get to a certain point in your startup company and you can't quite make it across that valley of death where you need to be able to have somebody to give you the capital to open the factory or to get the raw materials that you need. So that's the one case. Now, China, realizing that they have a huge opportunity here to win the clean energy race, put in about $30 billion a year, I think, over the last 50 years, the last 5 years. They put in so many billions of dollars, way, way, way more than we have in the United States. That's because that's what made them able to scale up so quickly. The government was behind them. Of course, they have a different setup for government. They have a top-down command and control economy. But because of that, they did it. They made it happen.
So, but in the long run, they get cheaper, more efficient energy,
right?
Thereby are more competitive than us because they bothered to invest that $30 billion.
Well, and they also flooded the market with cheap silicon. So that made it more difficult for American manufacturers in order to be able to keep up with the pace of what they were doing. And there's another problem here in the United States, just real quick, that we have all of these permitting issues and you have to go through about 18 months worth, depending on where you are, of trying to get through permits and other building issues in order to get solar panels on your roof, whereas over in Germany, it can be up in a matter of 2 to 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Because Germany has purposely taken a policy of streamlining so that these things go up very quickly. And there's a great book called The Clean Energy Break by Osha Gray Davidson, which talks about what Germany has done to be a world leader. They're winning the solar energy race right now.
So, and it's not that Americans are against winning. We love winning, right? We love to get new markets and expand into those, et cetera. It's just the people who make a lot of money in the old industries,
right,
don't want to give that money up, so they're invested in crushing new industries, and they have more money in the beginning that they can use in campaign donations, lobbying, et cetera, to crush the new industries. If we had a real free market, we'd probably be in much better shape, but the bottom line is, it is possible. If you do the right actions and you do the right investments, it is possible. And the fog story is encouraging too, you know, in a different
sphere.
Oh yeah,
there's all kinds of innovation going on all around the world, and it's unfortunate that people don't really hear about much of it, but it's everywhere. It's great. It's happening.
And you know where you can hear about it more? Green News Report at bradblog.com.